In today's video, I am breaking down Patrick Beverley's defense. The reason why is because we pulled a Patrick Beverley card as one of the best cards in a recent pack break. Definitely go check those out Thursday evenings. Let's get down and let's check out how Patrick Beverley plays defense. One of the great things that Patrick Beverley does is moving his feet extremely fast without crossing them so that he can stay between his man and the net. This is extremely great defense that we can break down. Okay, so to start, he does a quick stutter step and he stays up onto his toes and he tries to get his shoulders lower than his opponent's shoulders. That is one of the number one things that we should do as defenders. Next, that player decides to drive left on Beverley. As we can see, if we go back a frame or two, Patrick Beverley is not forcing this player to go left or right. He is playing him straight up. He's not forcing one way or the other. This way, he puts himself at the advantage because now he can go either way that this player wants to go, and obviously that offensive player is going to go towards his strong side. That way, Patrick Beverley can get in front, cut him off, and then force him towards the direction as to where he does not want to go. We always get caught up into trying to force that player towards his weak hand. Instead, we should straight up face him and then let him go towards his strong side. That way we can cut him off and then finally make him go towards his weak side. And that's what we see here. He's able to stick with that offensive player. That offensive player is forced to then switch directions now towards his weaker side. Patrick Beverley then stays in front. When this player goes up for that shot fake, Patrick Beverley does not leave the ground, instead stays in front and keeps his hands straight up. Now, of course, he is slightly fouling that player and right in view sight of that referee, but he does not get that call, and you don't always get a call if it's a fast move because he does release him quite quickly and he does get the block on that shot. And then that player is now surrounded by four players, two of which being extremely great defenders, and he is forced to kick the ball out. Now, the reason why this is so good, even though this is an okay three-point shooter, you would never want to have an easy basket in the key because the three-point shot is, in theory, a lower percentage shot. Now, in this next clip, we have LeBron passing that ball in for an alley-oop to Anthony Davis, but Patrick Beverley intercepts that pass. Why is that such a great play? Well, actually, it's not even Patrick Beverley's man, but he is playing help defense. The ball is on this side, which means that he should be two big steps away. That would be one big step. This would be two. He is on that block. Now, if you've got the ability to jump and they try to send up a lob pass over top, then you can go and disrupt that pass if you can, or at least make it hard for that pass to get through, and you'll be a very good defender from the help side. Now, in this next clip, we're going up against James Harden. James Harden is a very good left-handed player, and obviously, we do not want him driving left. And Patrick Beverley here, he's able to cut him off and stay on his hip, and then also Paul George does come down to try and cut off that drive. Now, Westbrook is not that great of a three-point shooter. He's okay. And because of that, Paul George is able to leave his man, stop James Harden from driving towards the basket, and then from there, James Harden is forced to go back out towards the three-point line. But now we can see that instead of front-facing our man, because that's not going to work, we do not want to allow James Harden to have either side because he can go either way strong. And it's just one of those things where you really need to pick your poison. Do you want him to have the option to go left or right? Or do you want to really ride his hip? Now, when you're going up against a really strong player towards one side, for example, we have James Harden, who is a very good left-handed player. If you can ride his left hip, you are now, and this is what I mean by riding left hip, you are literally on his left hip. This makes it really hard for him to shoot left-handed. Even if he was to drive towards the right side, because he is such a left-handed player, he cannot finish very at a high level with either hand if he was to drive towards the rim. Plus, there's a very strong post defender. You are now forcing him to take a shot that's not very good. And Patrick Beverley notices that with James Harden's shot, this is what I mean by when I tell players to really watch tape. or really watch players who are playing before you so that you can see how they shoot. Because James Harden actually has a shot form that brings that ball up way in front of his body. And if you can time that right, you can then block that shot before he even gets up into his shooting form, into his set point. Now, if James Harden could have brought that ball up a little bit closer to his body, which is something that we don't usually teach, that may not have happened. But because Patrick Beverley was riding his hip, things like this will happen if you play defense like that. On the fast break, let's not forget to take those charges. If you have a player who is driving towards the rim, whether he's going to pass or shoot, if you can take that charge, even after he passes that ball, you can become a great defender as well. Now, even though there may be a height advantage here, you can, as a defender, play really strong post defense. And this is how you can do this. We can see that he is getting his elbow into the lower back of that post player. He has a lot of his weight going into not allowing that player to back him down. Now, when this player turns, he actually plants his right foot first. And if you're a post defender and you're a good post defender, you can actually just notice this happening because you can feel or see that left leg not hit the ground first. You can see it hitting the ground last, which means that if he twists this way and brings his left foot back, it means he's actually going towards that left side. And because of that, Patrick Beverley is able to block that shot. Now, you have to know as a player, as a defender, how far they're going to bring that ball out away from their body. As a post offensive player, you want to keep that ball chest high when you turn instead of bringing it down to your hips. But because he brought it down to his hips, maybe Patrick Beverley seen that as a highlight or as they watch the film breakdowns of themselves. Obviously, each team has scouts and tells them what the tactics or things that the other team does. And because of that, he's able to get that block. So this is the red parallel card that we got from one of our pack breaks. Definitely go check out our live streams on Thursday evenings. And of course, you can ask any basketball related question that you would like. That's the reason behind this video is because Patrick Beverley was one of the best cards we drew from a couple of weeks ago at least. And I'll see you guys in my next video. I hope that you have enjoyed. I hope that this video has helped you become a better basketball player. I'll see you guys again in our next video.